We read again, two witnesses will appear in Israel. If you read Revelation chapter 11, verses 3 to 13, it talks to us, tells us about the ministry of the two witnesses. The who the two witnesses are, we do not know. The Bible is very silent. But if you look at the way the Bible describes it, it refers to or is very similar to the ministry of Moses and Elijah. So whether will they really be the two witnesses who will appear again on the face of this earth, we don't know. There are some schools of thought that says, yes, it's Moses and Elijah who will come again. And there's another school of thought that says it will be Elijah and Enoch, because these are the two men who did not taste death. So they go on arguing, you know. It is appointed for man to die once, and then comes the judgment. So Moses has died, therefore he cannot come back again in the flesh as a human. Now, I'm not here to judge which school is right, which school is wrong. But one thing I can tell you, our ways are not God's ways. The way that we think, the way that we understand death as it is written, is not exactly how it actually appears to be. When the Bible says God buried Moses, what does it really mean? Does it really mean like how we bury one another? There must be something different. If Moses was buried in a manner like how we bury one another, why need God come to do that? He could have asked Joshua to do it. Right? Just think for a moment now. He could have asked any one of the Israelites or Aaron and Ur. Oh, Aaron's already gone. So Caleb and Joshua or Ur. Okay, you bury Moses. But the Bible specifically says God buried Moses. So what does that burial really mean? We don't know. So just because we don't know, it does not mean that he cannot come again in the flesh like Elijah. Right? Are you with me?
Yes.
All right. Am I going out into Milky Way? We must break all this box of theology that we have. Throw away that box of theology.